Blue Origin has revealed a model of the Blue Moon lander, which they believe will be prepared for a journey to the moon in the next 3 years. This significant step will pave the way for future human landings on a more substantial vehicle, potentially by the end of the decade. During a visit to Blue Origin's engine production facility in Huntsville, Alabama, Jeff Bezos, the billionaire founder of the company, proudly showcased the low-fidelity mock-up to NASA officials. The lander is undeniably impressive in size, and will make full use of the generous 23-foot-wide payload volume provided by Blue Origin's new Glenn rocket. The Blue Moon Mark I is a lunar cargo lander, designed by Blue Origin to transport up to 3 metric tons of cargo on the moon. It is part of Blue Origin's commitment to providing reliable and affordable access to the lunar environment. The lander remains on the lunar surface, serving as a secure base for operations. Blue Origin was selected by NASA as a trusted lunar lander contractor, highlighting their expertise in space exploration. The Mark I is a precursor to the larger Mark II lander, which will transport astronauts to and from the moon. Blue Origin's vision is to enable global landing capability on the moon, regardless of the time of day. This commitment to accessibility and versatility showcases their determination to make lunar exploration accessible to all. Overall, the Blue Moon Mark I promises to revolutionize space exploration and pave the way for scientific discovery and human exploration on the moon. NASA's first landing target for Artemis is the lunar South Pole, where scientists have discovered evidence for large deposits of water ice in the bottoms of dark craters. There's a lot of work to do before that happens. With its $3.4 billion fixed-price human landing system contract with NASA, Blue Origin will be responsible for transporting astronauts between lunar orbit and the surface of the moon, then back into space, on the Artemis V mission. This mission is officially scheduled for no sooner than 2029, but is likely to slip into the 2030s. NASA has contracted with SpaceX for 2 crew lunar landings, with its giant Starship vehicle on the Artemis III and Artemis IV missions, officially slated for late 2025 and 2028. Those missions are also likely to be delayed, with schedule pressures, ranging from the readiness of the Starship lander and spacesuits, to the construction of a new mobile launch platform and an enlarged upper stage for NASA's Space Launch System rocket. SpaceX's priority, for now, is to get the Starship rocket into orbit, and then the company needs to test refueling technology in space, a capability that will require numerous successful Starship launches. Then SpaceX plans to fly an unpiloted demonstration mission to land Starship on the moon, ahead of the first crew flight. It's not just SpaceX's readiness that concerns NASA about the schedule for Artemis III. "We have a whole bunch of components that have to come together for Artemis III," said Jim Free, the senior NASA manager who oversees the Artemis program. "We've got a whole new Orion that's going to have a docking system on it. We should never rest on our laurels on SLS. That's got to come together because we build a whole new vehicle every time. We need suits to come together, and as the suits are very much in their early technical phase of design and development, nobody should rest easy," Free said. "Every single contractor has got to perform on every mission, and they have to do it to a higher level than they ever have because now we're flying humans," he said. Blue Origin's HLS architecture is similar to that of SpaceX in that it also requires refueling in space. But Blue Moon uses liquid hydrogen as a fuel, while SpaceX's Starship burns liquid methane. Blue Origin will also launch its landers aboard the company's new Glenn rocket, which is not expected to launch until late next year at the earliest. For each human-rated lander mission, Blue Origin needs 3 new Glenn launches, one to send the lander to an orbit around the moon, then 2 more launches to carry parts for a Lockheed Martin-built refueling tug to fill the lander's tanks in lunar orbit. Astronauts flying from Earth on NASA's SLS rocket and Orion spacecraft will link up with the landers from SpaceX or Blue Origin, depending on the mission, in orbit around the moon, then ride to the lunar surface. The landers will transport the crews back to the Orion spacecraft for return to Earth. Blue Origin's Mark I lander will first fly to the moon on a demonstration mission, with additional flights planned to carry science payloads to the lunar surface. The first 2 Mark I missions are scheduled to fly no later than 2026, according to Aviation Week. Bezos first revealed the Blue Moon lander program in 2019, and he presented a spacecraft that looks a lot different from the one Blue Origin is working on today. It used the same hydrogen-fueled B-7 engine, another Blue Origin product in development, but the Blue Moon cargo lander Bezos showed off 4 years ago was shorter and squatter. Then Blue Origin partnered with a so-called national team of space industry giants in 2019 to bid for NASA's first HLS contract. This consortium included Northrop Grumman, Lockheed Martin, and Draper Laboratory, and the lander design would have included three distinct parts. NASA picked SpaceX over the Blue Origin proposal in 2021, then Blue Origin filed a lawsuit to protest NASA's choice of SpaceX. After a court dismissed the suit, Blue Origin went back to the drawing board and came up with a fully reusable lander design. After it's done with its first Artemis landing, the Mark II lander can loiter in lunar orbit for refueling ahead of additional landing missions. But Blue Origin and SpaceX need to prove they can safely land on the moon, before NASA will put its astronauts onboard Blue Moon or Starship. The Mark I lander announced Friday will move Blue Origin in that direction. Koulouris, who oversees the Blue Moon program at Blue Origin, said this week Blue Origin is working on light detection and ranging litter technology to enable precision landings on the moon. NASA has a requirement to land within 100 meters within a designated location, he said Wednesday at Wernher von Braun Symposium in Alabama. We utilize litter terrain relative navigation to get that day-night capability, looking for landmarks. He said, tests of the navigation sensors during landings of Blue Origin's suborbital New Shepard rocket have shown it could be used to land with a precision of single-digit meters. We are a hydrogen-based vehicle, Koulouris said. We do that not only because it's one of the most energetic combinations of propellants, but it also allows us to provide our reaction control system propellants and our power. So we utilize fuel cells for the night side and solar arrays for the day side, but eventually we look to evolve that to regenerative fuel cells so that we'll start electrolysis of water. Liquid hydrogen is notoriously difficult to handle. It has to be stored at super cold temperatures or else it will boil off. And its shelf life in space has historically been measured in hours, not in days, weeks, or months. Blue Origin has agreements with NASA to develop cryogenic fluid management and fluid transfer tech, what Koulouris described as the couplers and the pumps to transfer cryogenics from refuelers to landers. The long-term vision is to tap into ice on the moon to generate hydrogen and liquid oxygen rocket propellants. At best, that's still a decade or two away from happening at a level meaningful for producing rocket fuel. If we can make hydrogen a storable propellant, with zero boil-off systems, we're now not only unlocking lunar resources, but the potential to open things such as NTP nuclear thermal propulsion, or other propulsion technologies that go beyond, Koulouris said. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.